Chapter 1. Curvy Beak, Pointy Claws.
I, Nate the Great, am a detective. Right now, I am a clickety-clack rocking back-and-forth detective. I am on a train. My dog Sludge is with me. He is a detective, too. We are on a case. We are bodyguards for an owl. Her name is Hoot. She belongs to my cousin, Olivia Sharp. The case started this morning. Sludge and I were visiting Olivia in San Francisco. Olivia is also a detective. This morning, she said,
Hoot needs to take a train to a special owl doctor in Los Angeles.
A plane is faster, I said.
Hoot doesn't like to fly.
She said, I, Nate the Great, say that is a good enough reason for an owl to see a doctor. Olivia tossed her boa around her neck. She always wears a boa.
Glad you think so,
she said. Then she tossed her boa around my neck, looked me straight in the eye, and said,
You'll take Hoot on the train for me. I know I can count on you.
Olivia pulled me over to a covered birdcage. She lifted the cover. I looked into two huge staring eyes. Then I saw a big head, a curvy beak, and sharp pointy claws. What big eyes she has, I said.
Yes, and she's easy to feed,
Olivia said.
She eats mice.
You have told me, Nate the Great, more than I want to know. But Olivia wasn't finished.
Chapter 2. Wanted, a bodyguard.
I will catch up with you later,
Olivia said. How? Where? When?
When the time is right,
she said.
But for now, Willie will drive the three of you in my limo to the train station.
Willie is Olivia's chauffeur. We had worked on another case together. I knew him well. Anything else I should know? I asked.
Just one little thing,
Olivia said.
You'll be a bodyguard.
What? Who am I guarding?
Hoot, of course.
Hoot? Why does Hoot need a bodyguard? Olivia handed me a piece of paper.
Look at this,
she said. I, Nate the Great, read. It will be a happy day when Hoot the Owl flies away. Your neighbor. I said. Do you think someone in this building is trying to get rid of Hoot?
Yes, and I made sure all the neighbors know that Hoot will be on the train today. So, if the note writer takes the train and tries to get at Hoot, we'll catch him or her.
Good plan, I said. But why aren't you Hoot's bodyguard? Olivia tossed her boa.
Because my neighbors know that I know what they look like. If they see me on the train, I might scare them off. That's why I need you.
And that's how I, Nate the Great, became a bodyguard for an owl.
Chapter 3. All aboard.
Sludge and I got into the back of the limo. Willie was already in the front seat with the covered cage beside him. I was glad it was not beside me. Willie turned around.
Miss Olivia wants Hoot to get a good day's sleep,
he said.
So, keep her cage covered.
No problem, I said. But is an owl allowed on a train? And a dog?
Miss Olivia took care of everything.
Willie said, I believe it, I said. Willie started the limo, and we were off. I took a pad of paper and a pencil from my pocket. I wrote a note to my mother. Dear Mother, I have a new case. It is in a cage. I hope to keep it there. I will be back. Love, Nate the Great. When we got to the train station, I handed the note to Willie.
A note for your mother, Mr. Great? I will send it to her.
Thank you, I said. On the train, Willie carried the cage down the aisle. Sludge was sniffing. People were staring at us. At last, Willie stopped at a door. He opened it. We went into a room. Willie put the cage on a table, patted Sludge, saluted, and left. And there we were, the three of us, Hoot, Sludge, and me.
Chapter 4. Achoo!
The train pulled out of the station. Sludge kept looking at the cage. Was he trying to be a good bodyguard? Or was he afraid of Hoot? I am going out to see what I can learn, I said. Stay here and guard Hoot. Sludge did not look happy. I opened the door, walked out, and closed the door behind me. There was a room next to mine. The door was open. A man and a woman were inside. Hello, I said. Do you know an owl named Hoot? The man laughed.
Hoot who?
I walked on. Two boys were coming down the aisle. Do you know an owl named Hoot? I asked. They laughed.
Hoot toot toot.
I walked on. I saw another open door. Inside, a lady was soaking her feet. Do you know an owl named Hoot? I asked.
Yes, she lives in my building.
I see, I said. Is anyone else from your building on this train?
Yes, two men. One is a musician. He's in the lounge. I don't know where the other man is.
Last question. Do you like Hoot? The lady scrunched up her face.
She makes me sneeze. Duck, I'm about to sneeze right now.
Thank you for the information, I said. I will use it right now, especially the last part. I ducked and rushed away. I knew that lady had a reason for not liking Hoot.
Chapter 5. The Lookalike.
I walked on. I passed rows of people. They were sitting, talking, reading, sleeping, or just looking out the windows. I found the lounge. I saw a man with a guitar. My name is Nate the Great, I said. Tell me, do you like Hoot the Owl?
Sure,
he said.
She screeches, and it's like music to my ears.
Glad to hear that, I said. Now, I'm looking for another man who knows Hoot. The musician smiled.
The Owl Man. He looks like an owl. He's sitting back there. You'll know him when you see him.
Thank you, I said.
I'm writing a song about sounds.
The musician said.
A wolf can howl without a towel, but sometimes needs to use a vowel.
Well, have a good time trying to rhyme, I said.
Hey, nice rhyme.
The musician said. I walked back to where people were sitting in rows. I stared at everyone. Then I saw a man wearing a spotted shirt and big yellow glasses. His hair stuck up in two points. The Owl Man. I bent over him. Perhaps you like Hoot the Owl, I asked.
Perhaps I don't,
he said.
People keep telling me I look like her big brother.
I walked on. Maybe who did need a bodyguard? Three people who knew her were on this train. Two of those people might not like her. I went back to my room. I opened the door. Sludge was standing there, with his ears perked up, like a good bodyguard. He wagged his tail. I looked at Hoot's cage. It was just where Wooly had put it. Fine job, Sludge, I said. Sludge wagged his tail again. Time to rest, I said. I sat down on a couch. I looked out the window. I saw trees going by, and mountains, and lakes. I closed my eyes.
Chapter 6, The Cage.
I heard a voice. It belonged to my friend Annie. She was talking in rhyme.
Do you know where you are? Take a big guess. You're asleep on this case, on the Owl Express.
What was Annie doing on this train? Then I heard a strange voice. It belonged to Rosamond. She's the only strange person I know. She was also talking in rhyme.
Don't snooze, find clues, try hard, bodyguard.
I sat up suddenly. I, Nate the Great, had been asleep. Had I been working on the case in my dreams? Why did bad rhymes get into my dreams? Perhaps I was trying to give myself a clue. I looked at the cage. Was Hoot still asleep? Was she hungry? Was she happy? I, Nate the Great, hoped the answers were yes, no, and yes. I got up and walked to her cage. Willie had told me to keep it covered. He had told me to let Hoot sleep. But I, Nate the Great, had a job to do. I lifted the cover. Hoot wasn't asleep, or hungry, or happy. She was gone.
Chapter 7, Pancake Time.
Had something happened while I was asleep? Sludge was standing by the door. He would have barked or growled if anyone had tried to come in. I stared at the cage. The cover looked the same as before. I peered inside. There was a door, and it was closed. There were perches, and they looked clean. Everything looked clean. Whoever had taken Hoot had been careful to leave everything neat. But who had taken her? And how? I needed time to think. I needed pancakes. Wait here, Sludge, I said. I rushed to the dining car. I sat down. A waiter came over. Has anyone ordered a mouse to go? I asked. The waiter laughed.
Oh, a mouse?
Did you know there's an owl on this train? I asked. The waiter shrugged.
I heard people talking about it, but nobody seems to have seen it.
I, Nate the Great, was getting nowhere. May I have some pancakes and one bone, please?
We have pancakes with a wonderful fruit syrup.
The waiter said. Fine, I said. The food came fast. I stared down at it. The bone looked normal, but my plate was dripping with syrup.
Doesn't that look wonderful?
The waiter said. No, I said. It looks like a swamp made of syrup. The waiter smiled.
This is a blanket of syrup. The pancakes are tucked in under it.
Tucked in? The pancakes are asleep? Never mind. I'm hungry. I ate and thought. Did I have any clues? Yes. My biggest clue was that Sludge is a great detective. He had kept wagging his tail as if nothing had happened. As if no one had come into the room. And I had other clues. I finished my pancakes, put the bone in my pocket, and walked back to my room. I opened the door. Sludge wagged his tail. I gave him the bone. We have solved the case, I said. I picked up the owl cage. This cage is clean. No stray feathers. No bits or pieces of anything. This is a new cage. Never used. Also, a waiter told me that nobody seems to have seen the owl. I, Nate the Great, say that nobody includes us. You and I never saw Hoot in this cage because she was never in it.
Chapter 8, Sidetrack.
Sludge looked puzzled. You're right, I said. We have not solved the case. We still don't know who wrote the note. And we don't know why Olivia wanted us to guard an empty cage. She planned this well. She didn't want me to look in the cage. That's why I was told that Hoot needed a good day's sleep. She told me about the mice to make sure I wouldn't try to feed Hoot. And now, here we are. You, me, and an empty cage on a train on the way to Los Angeles. Olivia said she would catch up with us. How could she be sure of that? I, Nate the Great, knew the answer. Sludge and I stretched out on a couch. Good detectives know when to take action and when to wait. This was a time to wait. We waited and waited. At last, a piece of paper was slipped under our door. I picked it up. There was a message on it. Olivia Sharp here, in the private car at the end of the train. Since you are a great detective, you have figured out. A. I have been on this train all the time. B. You are a bodyguard for a decoy. Come on, Sludge, I said. Sludge and I walked to the last car. I knocked on the door. Come in, Olivia called. Sludge and I walked in. Olivia was sitting behind a huge desk with a computer, a telephone, and piles of paper.
I'm at work, she said. I'm writing up reports on my last 5 cases.
Where is Hoot? I asked.
Hidden on the train, Olivia said.
Why didn't you tell me the cage was empty? I asked. Olivia tossed her boa.
Because I knew that you and Sludge would not want to guard something that was nothing.
Good thinking. Olivia stood up.
So, did you find out who wrote the note?
Yes, but Sludge and I must leave. We will be back soon.
Chapter 9, The Great Train Detective.
Sludge and I were back in 10 minutes with the lady with very clean feet, the musician, and the owl man. Everybody, please sit down, I said. I turned to the lady. Who makes you sneeze? But you sneezed when I was with you, and who wasn't? So other things must make you sneeze too.
Yes,
she said.
Turnips, glue, petunias, dirty feet, cats, chewing gum, anything pink, fresh air, and spiders.
So if Hoot wasn't around, you would still sneeze?
Yes.
Then maybe you do like Hoot.
Nice owl, good manners.
I turned to the musician. You like Hoot, correct?
Yes,
said the musician. I turned to the owl man. You do look like an owl, I said. But that's because you want to. You wear spotted shirts. You comb your hair into 2 points, and you wear big yellow glasses. You like looking like Hoot. I, Nate the Great, say that none of you have a reason for writing a terrible note about Hoot. Then I turned to the musician. You wrote the note.
What?
The musician stood up.
I did not write a terrible note. I like owls.
I believe you, I said. Olivia walked up to me.
Did you solve this case or not?
She asked. Yes, I, Nate the Great, say that the note was a get-well note. Olivia pulled the note out of her pocket.
It says that it will be a happy day when Hoot the Owl flies away. How can that be a get-well note?
I turned to the musician again. You have a little trouble writing rhymes, right?
Yes, and I needed something to rhyme with day. It was a good, friendly note.
I, Nate the Great, see that things that look good to somebody can look terrible to somebody else. Today I was served food that looked good to the waiter and bad to me. I turned to Olivia. End of case. Hoot is safe. Olivia tossed her boa into the air.
You were fabulous,
she said. No, I said. Actually, I was only great. The boa landed on Sludge.
I will give you anything you want,
Olivia said.
Make a list.
I reached into my pocket. Sludge and I came prepared, I said. I handed Olivia a piece of paper. Wand, 25 bones, 25 pancakes without syrup. Do not want. Cage, with or without owl, boa, tossed or otherwise. Now, tell me exactly where Hoot is, I said.
She's still on the train,
Olivia said. Suddenly, I, Nate the Great, knew Olivia had given me a clue I did not want. Sludge and I went back to our room and sat by the window. We were not alone.